Hello everyone, today we will learn about the input devices. First we have to know about the what is computer. A computer is an electronic device which is used to manipulate the data. And computer has the ability to store, retrieve and process the data. And we can use the computer to type the documents, send emails, play games and browse in the web, etc. and many things. We can also use the computer to edit or create the spreadsheets, presentations, documents and even videos also. And computer process the numerical as well as the non-numerical calculations. The term computer is derived from the Latin word computare, which means to calculate. And computer is designed to execute applications and provide the variety of solutions through the hardware and software components. Computer has memory which is used to store the data, programs and result of the processed data. The components of the computer such as wires, transistors, circuits, hard disks are called the hardware, and the programs and the data are called the software. The analytical engine was the first computer which was invented by the Charles Babbage in 1837. So Charles Babbage is known as the father of the computer. And this analytical engine used punched cards as the read-only memory. So the first computer is the analytical engine. In this video we learn about the input-output devices. An input device sends information to the computer for processing, and output device reproduces or displays the results of that processing. Input devices are used to give input to the computer system, and with the help of these input devices we can interact with the computer. For example, keyboard, mouse, joysticks, touchpad, touch screen, these all are the input devices. And these keyboard and mouse are the most important input devices. We call these as the standard input devices. Without these keyboard or mouse, we cannot interact with the computer. And next is the output devices, which are used to give the final result to the user, which is given by the computer processor. The examples for the output devices is monitor, printer, speakers, etc. Monitor is the main output device of the computer. So we call the monitor as the standard output device. Most devices are either used as the input or output devices. But some of the devices which accepts input and display the output, those are referred as the input output devices. And these are usually called as the I/O devices. And these are directly connected to an electronic module inside the system unit called the device controller. For example, speakers of the multimedia are directly connected to a device controller called the audio card. This is also known as the sound blaster, and which in turn connected to the rest of the system. And some of the secondary memory devices like the hard disk are called the I/O devices, because by using the hard disk we can write the data into the hard disk, and as well as we can accept the data from those devices. So we call the hard disk as the I/O device. Input device. Some of the input devices are mouse, keyboard, joystick, microphone, touchpad, light pen, trackball, scanner and digital camera. These are the some of the input devices. We can learn in detail about all these things. Keyboard is the primary input device, and we can also know this as the standard input device, which is used to give the input to the computer. This is similar to the electronic typewriter. This is the example of the keyboard, one of the example of the keyboard which is used to the give input to the computer, and it is the modified version of the typewriter. And this keyboard is composed of buttons used to create the letters, numbers, symbols, and also perform the additional function. Generally, the keyboard has a 104 keys, but nowadays it is modified. It come with the more than 104 keys. The example of the keyboard is looks like this. This is the keyboard, and this is the wrist pad. These are the arrow keys used to move up, down, left, and right. This is the keyboard. This is also known as the number keypad, which consists the numbers and symbols. This is the these are the function keys, which starts with F1, F2 up to F10, and these are the control keys, which are used to control the home, end, page up, page down, delete, insert. These all are keys, and these are the indicators, which specifies when we are pressing the number lock, it highlights. So we say that number lock is on, caps lock. When we press the caps lock, it button highlights, it on. So we know that caps lock is on. Like the scroll lock indicator, all those. These are the alphabets and enter keys. Many of more of the keys. This is the window button. All those are the keys present in the keyboard. And the mouse is the another input device, and it is also known as the handheld hardware input device, which controls the cursor in the graphical user interface. That means when we want to select the graphics, means icons, pictures, those can be easily selected by using the mouse. And with the help of this, we can move and select the text, icons, files, folders on the computer. And it is also known as the pointing device. And it comprises of the three buttons, left, right, and top. And also one trackball at the bottom, which helps to selecting moving the mouse around respectively. And this is the wheel, which is used to scroll up and down in the page and menu. And this is the left key, which is used to select an object. And this is the cable, which is used to connect to the computer. And this is the right click to open the context sensitive menus. And in the bottom, it has the device. The mouse can be of the mechanical or optical. When it is the optical, it uses the LED light inside it. When it is the mechanical, it has the inner. It in the below of the mouse, it has the ball. Okay, this is the another standard input device, which is used to select the graphics, icons, folders, files easily. A joystick. This is the input device which is used to control a character or a machine in the computer program. This is the input image of the joystick, and this is the in such as a plane in the flight simulator. This is similar to the simulator of the flight. Okay, it is generally used to control the games, video games, to control the movement of the video games. This can be used, and a device which comprises a stick, which is attached at an angle to the base. This is the base, and this is a stick, so that it can be moved and controlled. This is the stick. By using this moving like this and flight simulator, we can control the games or play the games. And this is also used in the cockpit of an aeroplane, wheelchairs, cranes, trucks, etc., to operate them well. This is the another input device which is mainly used to control the movement of the video games. And another input device, that is the light pen. This is the light sensitive pointing input device commonly used to select or otherwise modify text data on the screen, and it works with the CRT monitors. This is a CRT monitor. This is the light pen, which is used to control this, and it is a wand-like looking device which can directly be moved over the device's screen. And nowadays we are using the stylus pen. Okay, this is the and the CRT this light pen is the oldest model of the pen, that is a stylus. We now and this is used to operate the touch screens like that, but this light pen is used to operate the CRT monitors. Okay, and this stylus pen is used with the graphic tablets. Okay, this is the another input device which can be used to give the input by operating this pen on the screen. And another input device, that is the microphone. This is the looking of the microphone. This is one of the example I have given here, and this allows the computer user to input audio into their computers. By using this microphone, sound can be stored in a device in the digital form, and it converts the sounds into the electric signals, and it can also use to record or reproduce a sound created using this microphone, and this needs to be connected to with an amplifier. This is the another input device which we can frequently use. And another input device is the scanner. And this is the also known as the optical scanner. This is the hardware input device which optically reads an image and converts into the digital signal. When we put some of the object into the scanner, it reads an image by using this digital signal, optical light. Any device or document on the scanner converts this digital signal in and displays that screen onto the computer screen. Okay, this is looks like this. And another input device is the barcode reader. And this is also the one kind of the optical scanner. This is the picture of the barcode reader, and it can read the barcodes. It is used to read the barcodes. Nowadays in the supermarkets, many of the shopping centers maximum these barcode readers are used, and this barcode is the combination of some lines. By using this barcode reader or barcode scanner, it displays the information related to those lines. Okay, and the source of light is passed through a barcode. This light is passed this, and its aspects and details are displayed on the screen. If the barcode has inbuilt screen, it displays on the screen. Otherwise, it displays when it which it is connected. If we connect this to the computer monitor or display displays the information related to this barcode. And today many smartphones with the proper applications are also capable of scanning and reading these barcodes. These are some of the input devices and input output devices. Okay, so as we learn, some of the devices act as the input device, otherwise some devices act as the only output. But we have many devices which can act as the input as well as the output device. Some of those are the which receive data from the user or another input device and send data to another device, that is output. For example, those are the CD, RW drive, DVD, RW drive, which receives data from a computer, that is the input, to copy onto writable CD or DVD. Also, drive sends data contained on a CD to a computer. That means we can write the data to the CD or DVD, which is rewritable, and we can also access or extract the data which is in the CD or the DVD. So that CD read RW or DVD RW is working as the input as well as the output device. And another input output device is the USB flash drive, which receives or saves data from the computer and also the drive sends data to a computer. That is the another input device. That means from the USB drive, we can input to the computer, and as well as the from the computer we can output the files to the USB drive. So USB flash drive and CD read write drives are act as the input output devices or IO device. Okay, thank you one and all. Don't forget to subscribe my channel.